a ghetto in West Africa.
Just like the river I've been running ever since. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will.
Who knows? I just go where the trade wind blows, sending love to my friends and foes, and I suppose.
So we're here today in Medina. It's Monday, bank holiday in England, but a normal day in Ghana. And we're in the ghetto in Medina, as you can see, with the man them, yeah? And we're just going to have a quick preview of the pros and cons on tramadol and all these other hardcore drugs, you get me? So anyway, Black Lives Matter, the youths matter, innit? And come for change your thing, isn't it?
Yeah, so this is a Twin Tins initiative, and we are here basically to talk to the ghetto youth. We are in Ghana, West Africa, Medina to be precise. And we are here to talk to the youth them about drug abuse, abstinence from drugs, with all these likes of tramadol, raffinol, what you call it, codeine, and all these other drugs that the youth abuse. So I am Maron Wula, and this is Leila Hunt. Together we do this.
So at this present moment, we enter the ghetto of Medina.
I beg, what be your name?
Me, I'll be Malo. Yeah, I'll be Malo.
You know,
yeah, Malo.
Oh, wow.
He's
my
good.
Name is Maron.
Maron.
Yeah.
Wow, it's good that you people came here to, you know, to educate us about how to put a stop to all these drugs thing, you know, because seriously, this thing, it's not easy. It's killing the youths, and you know, it's making a lot of youths going astray, yeah, doing a whole lot of things. So it's good that you people have come here, and it's good that you said it. You've said something that we have to learn from you. So we try to put a stop, and I'm saying to all the ghetto youths, everyone, to just
abstain.
Yeah, to just put a stop, to give a stop to hard drugs and all those stuff. Yeah.
Throughout our interviews in Medina, we got to find out from the ghetto youths certain precautions and certain disadvantages of taking such drugs as cocaine, tramadol and codeine and such others. We also bucked up on a specific guy what told us more about his experience with cocaine and other drugs. So this is it.
And be doing drugs. You need to abstain today. It's the best for you, my brother. It's the best for you. You need to abstain because we need you alive. We need you alive to be always here with us. This is what we are talking about. This is why we are embarking on this journey. This is why we are sending this message across. We need you to quit the drugs that you are doing because it is no good, basically. Charlie Treasure, thanks too much, man. You have said everything. I beg anybody who wants to share any experience or anything. I beg you get any experience. What be your name?
My name is Mr. Birdman.
Mr. Birdman.
Yeah.
I beg you get any experience.
Yeah.
You get any experience with all these drugs, tramadol, raffinol, codeine, anything, any experience, share with us.
Yeah, I've experienced that before. You need to cut my ear. That one be raffinol level. So still no to raffinol. But I'll tell you the truth. Right now I've already taken two. But still no to raffinol.
Yeah.
But my boss who spoiled me with those kind of tramadol level. He advised me that I should take that thing. So go to raffinol, they take them codeine. I've appreciated your advice. So I'll stop to taking those
kinds. So if you take Amma, how you feel? When you take the codeine and the raffinol, how you feel?
I'm feeling like I'm stronger than everyone in this world. I can even swallow you yourself.
You can swallow me?
Yes.
Wow.
Right now, I need like from certain help, like camping me in some house, feeding me for a while, like in 1 month time, so that I can stay out in those kind of level.
You know, say, this is my brother where he a bad man. He no go fit either in one corner. He won't bring Graphenol or codeine into the system.
Yeah.
Or he won't bring Tramadol into the system. The people who are bringing it are the very big men who are supposed to protect us.
Yes.
They are the one who is who are making businesses out of this hard drugs. You understand? Because if they don't import it, if they don't bring it down here, you understand? They get to you, where they go see Tramor for? I mean, just imagine, say, then they produce the Tramor from, let's say, Egypt, or they produce Tramor in Spain, or all the any other country that can come in your head, yeah? Think about it this way. This is my brother where they here. Where they go see for? If the big man no use in money, invest time karma. Where they go see for? So me, my humble appeal personally is that we need to, we the youth, as we make one of mind say we want to eradicate all this drug menace from our system, that means that we need to go on the streets and start addressing the big man them, because the big man them, where they invest the money, make the drugs, they come.
They are the importers.
You understand? They are the importers. They are the ones who are bringing the drugs. Then again, and then they will turn around and come and tell us that we are the ones who are doing the drugs. Yeah, you understand? Yeah, yeah. They are the same people who are bringing the drugs. Then they will turn around and tell us that we are there. You understand? I'm so vexed right now because I lost a brethren. You understand? I lost one of my brethren just last month, and it's due to taking all these kind of drugs. You understand? Name withheld. But I mean, listen, it's not right. You the Bible, it's not right. I mean, life the be.
My level.
It's bad.
Maybe today I don't get nothing, but tomorrow I go get something. And I go buy the motor for mama. But the enemy won't worry me. I go show all of them tragedy. No be today, we start to. So if I sing my song, if I keep up for long, because you don't know that day, oh, Jesus Christ, he go come. Oh. So if you see me today, I know my level.
Oh, God, you say Miranda.
No,
cheese.
No.
Wow.
Am I not allowed? Me too, we have to marry. We cannot marry. You will find your man. Oh, I'm sorry.
Jamma.
Sorry. If not that, we will fight.
Oh, you will fight?
Yes, we will fight.
Then we should put prices on it. I should put prices on it.
Ladies.
I'm sorry for that. I'm sorry.
Oh, my love.
Hi and good morning. My name is Layla Hunt and we're currently in Cape Coast. It's Thursday and
do you want to introduce yourself? Hi, good morning. My name is Marad Wula and we're here in Cape Coast today to do some short documentary from slavery time and link it up to our current project as Twinton's charity and on the use of drugs, abstinence of drugs, Tramadol, codeine, and what have you. So basically we're here to start the documentary this morning. And here we are.
We're currently here at a building which was built in 1939, that's like 79 years ago. You can see it's got like a slavery feel to it. I mean, we can go around.
It's an old building.
Yeah, it's really, really, really old.
A business school was that.
Yeah, they've actually turned it into a school now. If you come this way.
Now, as you can see, I think it's been a school since it was built. Okay. Like Catholic Jubilee School.
So
from 1892, 1940. So what you see here basically is a basic school that was built by the Catholic missions years back, 79 years back.
Well, who was a Catholic missions? Because my grandma was a Catholic, and I mean, she's in Jamaica. So So who are these Catholic people?
I don't need this life, yo, because I got my Bible, yo. Because the blessings I get from the Most High is so great.